Hi, my name is Sam. I'm an application developer with DB Services, and today I'll be showing you how to use polygons with the Google Maps JavaScript API to display custom region information within your FileMaker solution. The first thing that you're going to need to do is set up a Google Developer account and enable the Google Maps JavaScript API. I'm not going to go over that process in this video, but the steps for that process can be found in the associated article. That's also where you can download this example file to follow along with. After you create your Google Developer account and enable the Google Maps JavaScript API, you'll need to create an API key with the Create Credentials button on the Google Maps or the Google Developer console. After you get the API key, you can paste that here in the example solution and click Go to Example. When you click Go to Example, you'll see a few things. One is the web viewer containing the map. The second is a portal containing the polygons stored in FileMaker. And the third is a box below that allows you to specify the center of the default center of the map and where the pin in the center of the map is. You'll see two buttons at the top of the web viewer. The first allows you to move the map and you can change the zoom level with scrolling. The second allows you to start drawing a polygon, which is what we're primarily concerned with today. I can draw a polygon with any number of sides or corners. When I complete that polygon, you'll see a few things happen. One is that polygon fills in with the color, and second is that an associated FileMaker record appears in the portal to the right of the web viewer. We can rename this polygon to give it some meaning, so we'll call this the pink polygon. And we can also delete polygons using the trash can icon, and you'll see that they also will disappear from the map when we do this. So if I delete this green polygon, you can see it disappears along with the FileMaker record. We can change the center of the map using these coordinates down here. For instance, if we change this to 86 instead of negative 86 and refresh, it puts the center of our map in the pin in China where these coordinates are. But we'll change this back to here for now. The FileMaker functionality for this web viewer is fairly straightforward, and I'll show you that now. When we first enter this layout with the web viewer, you can see we use this start map script, and this just initializes the map. You can see all we're doing here is taking the center that we've defined in that box, running an initialize map or init map function in the web viewer code, and then restoring previously stored polygons. I'll show you this in app initialize map function here. This file represents the code that is stored in the field that the web viewer is based on. Anytime you use Google Maps in a FileMaker solution in a web viewer, you're gonna need something similar to this init map function, and you can do any number of things, but there are a few things that you have to do. One is define a map. So here we have a variable defined outside of the function called map, and here we create the map. There are many options here for the map that you can find in the Google Developer documentation, and that's true for basically any feature that's used in the solution. Here is basically just the bare bones, but I'll specify anything that's not obvious. So here we specify the center of the map and the zoom level starting out. This drawing manager that's defined here defines the, or is the reason we can draw polygons on the map. Basically, we're just creating a drawing manager object and then down here setting it to the map we just created. And you'll see this set map method on many different objects that we create to apply them to the map. The important thing here is that in drawing modes, under drawing control options, we've enabled the polygon option. And as you can see here, we've commented out a bunch of different drawing modes here, like circles, rectangles, and lines that wouldn't make polygons. And again, information on those can be found on the Google Developer documentation. But right now, we're just concerned with polygons. Each of these types also have a bunch of different options that we can specify. So for markers here, for example, we just can specify the icon that'll be used and then options for circles. You can also add listeners. This listener is the only one we have in this function. This listens for the completion of a polygon. Basically, when you connect the sides of a polygon, this function runs. This can do any number of things or very few things. In our version of the function, we just have it setting the color variable to a random color that will later be used as the color of the polygon, pulling the bounds of that polygon, and then sending that information to FileMaker using the FileMaker perform script function here. And we also set the marker for the center of the map that you saw earlier. So I'll show you that map store polygons. And similar to the start map, it's actually fairly simple. We're taking the parameter that was passed in from JavaScript, creating a new polygon record, and then setting that parameter as a field on the polygon. This basically allows us to repass those properties into the web viewer code when we need to restore that polygon. And that's done here when we, as you saw earlier, when we initialize the map. This is written to restore one or multiple polygons. If you pass in a polygon or a list of polygons, it will restore those. But if you don't pass any parameter, it will actually restore every polygon in the polygon table. We basically just have a variable list and then pass that return separated list into the function load maps in the web viewer. You can see we use that variable here. I'll show you that function here. We split that return separated list of polygon properties into an array so we can iterate over it and restore each of those polygons one by one. The relevant information that we're pulling in here is the color of the polygon, so we can display that correctly associated with that dot you saw in the portal in FileMaker. The bounds of the polygon, which is probably the most important, this defines the corners of the polygon, which we can recreate the shape with and the coordinates. And then finally, the key. We have a key. The primary key from FileMaker is just part of the polygon object in the JavaScript here, just so that if we need to do something to a specific polygon, we know how to identify it. Basically, that's used right now just to hide polygons when they're deleted, but you can use that for any number of purposes. This is how we create the polygon object. You can see the bounds variable here is to define the shape. We just have them all restored as the outside stroke as black. We have them with a constant opacity and then constant stroke weight. But again, those can be variable and you can define those. And then we have the fill color here set to the RGB values that were stored in FileMaker. And then after we're done creating that polygon object, we have to set it to the map. And then you can see here when we click the delete key, this is actually the function that's being run. We identify the polygon from the polygons array that we've defined here by the key, and then basically remove it from the map. So it's still part of that polygons array, but we're just hiding it until we reload that map. So now that I've explained the FileMaker and JavaScript sides of it, basically, hopefully you have a little bit better understanding of how this works when you actually draw a polygon, and you can see it appears on the map. No, we must have edited a script there. If you have any questions integrating this with your FileMaker solution, feel free to reach out to us. Otherwise, the rest of the instructions should be on the associated article. Thanks, and happy developing.